अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम योर टीचर आयशा अनवर। वी हैव बीन स्टडिंग चैप्टर नंबर 2 विच इज़ अबाउट ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इंट्रोडक्शन। वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड इट्स फंक्शन एंड इट्स इंटरफेसेस। अप टिल नाउ वी हैव कवर्ड इट्स 2 इंटरफेसेस, दैट इज command line interface or CLI, and the second one is menu driven interfaces. Today we are going to learn third type of interface, which is graphical user interface or GUI. Okay students, let's revise operating system interfaces CLI and menu driven and study about GUI. We have discussed that there are 3 type of interfaces: command line interface, menu driven interface and graphical user interface. We have covered first 2 of them, and today we are going to discuss the third type, which is graphical user interface. In CLI we discussed that it is a textual based input, and we have to memorize and type the commands, and to execute those commands we have to press the enter key in order to execute the commands. The most commonly used operating systems that have a CLI are DOS and Unix. DOS stands for disk operating system. It was an old operating system which was a single user and single tasking operating system, which means we cannot allow multiple users and even multiple programs to run at the same time. Its interface is like this, as shown in the figure, which has black background with the white text written on it. The second type of operating system that uses command line interface is a Unix, and a Unix was also an old operating system. It was introduced in 1969, but it is different from DOS because it allows different programs at the same time with the multiple users. So basically in the very beginning phases of Unix, it was introduced as command line, but later on its graphical user interface was also introduced. This is the interface of Unix operating system. The second type of interface is menu driven interface. In menu driven interfaces, the commands are present in the form of menus. User has to select from the menu and make the choices of different commands according to the task he has to perform. It is basically easy to use as compared to command line interface. And the devices such as mobile phones and iPod, previously the old function had mobile phones and iPod had menu driven interfaces, like the old Nokia set phones have menu driven interfaces. You have to go to the menu and you have to select the option games or messages, and like this, if you select the option messages, the next menu appears. For example, to write the new message, inbox, sent items, like this. And by selecting from the menu, you perform your desired task. Menu driven interface was used in novels, NetWare and ProDOS. These 2 are also operating systems. Novels NetWare was introduced in 1993. You can see its interface that is given in the diagram. Then the second one operating system which uses menu is known as ProDOS. Okay students, let's discuss the third type of interface of operating system, that is graphical user interface. We write it as GUI. It is basically a graphical interface which uses windows, icon, menus and pointers to operate the computer system. What is a window? A window is basically a rectangular portion on screen which is displayed for the information. For example, whenever you open a program or open a document, it is opened in a rectangular screen which is known as the window. The second term is icon. Icon is a graphical symbol that represents a file, folder, program or device. You see the different type of small pictures on your screen, on your desktop. Those small pictures or on your desktop are known as the icons. And the user has to select or make choices by using a pointing device such as mouse. You have noticed that whenever we use a computer, we use some sort of pointing device, either a mouse or a joystick or a touchpad when using a laptop. So with the help of those pointing device, a cursor appears on a screen which has some arrowhead shape like this. And this arrowhead shape is known as the pointer. With the help of the pointer, we can click and we can point different objects on the screen. So let's discuss the advantages of GUI or graphical user interface. They are easy to learn and use as compared to CLI and menu-driven interfaces. There is no need to memorize the commands because there are no commands used in graphical user interface. All the things, data, instructions, documents are present in the form of icons. It allows users to run more than one program at the same time. GUI is used in latest operating systems like Windows, and Windows operating system have the facility to run more than one program at a time. Most of the GUI provides good help facilities, which means that if we are having any confusion or we don't know how to perform a particular task, we simply go to the help facility which is provided in GUI interfaces, and with the help of that help facility, we can easily perform the task which we want to do. And the last one and the most important is many applications of program use the similar interfaces, which makes it easy for us to use. Because if you have noticed that there are similar faces of MS Word and MS Excel and PowerPoint, so we can easily use some application software because of the similar interfaces. Now, what are the disadvantages of GUI? As GUI has icons, pictures, pointers, each and everything is colorful, and so it takes a lot of memory to reside into the computer, and it needs a faster computer as compared to the other interfaces. And both of these two advantages is because of its high quality graphics. Because everything that is present in GUI is in form of pictures, files, icons, which are colorful and representable. That's why they take a lot of memory in hard disk, and they need faster computers to process the information. So the graphical user interface is used in three most famous operating systems, and those are Macintosh, Linux and Windows. Among these three, Windows operating system is most popular operating system, and most of us have Windows operating system in our computers and in laptops. First of all, we will discuss the Macintosh. Mac OS is basically the series of operating system developed by Apple Incorporation. Apple Incorporation is a company which makes computers, laptops, mobile phones. So the Macintosh operating system is developed by Apple Incorporation to be used in Macintosh computers. It was introduced in 1984 and the latest version of Macintosh operating system is Mac OS X, and basically it is a Unix based user friendly operating system. It is not much difficult to use, and it is used in iPhones, iPods, iPads and new Apple TVs. This is the interface of Mac operating system. You can see see the windows, icons, colorful objects on the screen, which makes it easy for us to use. The second operating system which has graphical user interface is Linux. It is a free open source operating system. Free open source means its code is available, and anyone, any computer expert or programmer can easily make amendments and make changes into the Linux operating system and upload it. It is faster but difficult to use as compared to the rest of two, that is Macintosh and Windows operating system. It is not as popular as Windows and Macintosh. It is unpopular among these three. Programmers can view, edit and publish an improved version just because it is an open source software. Linux operating system can installed on PCs, laptops, netbooks, mobile and tablet devices. And it can also be used on video game consoles, servers, supercomputers and more other devices. Some popular Linux operating system distributions include Debian, Ubuntu, Fedora, Red Hat and OpenSUSE. These are the different versions of Linux that are available in market for use. So it is the interface of Linux based operating system. You can see again the icons and the pictures that are available because it is a graphical user interface. And the third one and the most popular operating system that is that uses GUI is the Windows operating system. As we have already discussed, that it is the most popular operating system and it was developed by the Microsoft company. There are many versions of Windows operating system, for example Windows 95, Windows 98, Windows Millennium, Windows XP, Windows Vista, Windows 7, Windows 8 and the latest one is Windows 10. Windows 10 is also operable in Urdu language, but this feature wasn't available in the previous version of Windows. It is the interface of Windows 10. You can see icons and the menu and the colorful screen. Okay students, that's all for today. We have completed our topic, which is about the different interfaces available for operating systems. There are basically three type of interfaces that are available: CLI, menu driven and GUI. So what type of question comes into the paper about this topic? Most of the times there is a question in paper to compare CLI and GUI, or they may ask the reason why do you prefer GUI over CLI operating system interfaces. So all of us should know about its definition, their features and the most commonly used operating systems that have used CLI and GUI. From objective point of view, we should know about different versions of these operating systems. We should know their dates. Sometimes the question also appears like define novels, netware and prodos. So all of us should be able to define these operating systems, the interfaces with the relevant examples of their operating systems. If you are having any confusion, you can ask anytime. Thank you.
Okay, students, now I am going to show you the graphical user interface of Windows 10 operating system. As we have already discussed that Windows is a very commonly used operating system which has each and everything present in the form of icons, menus, windows and pointers. So I am going to show you these 3 to 4 things which are present in graphical user interface. First of all, you can see the desktop, this main screen. When we boot up our computer, this is the first screen which is loaded, and this first screen is known as the desktop. If you look at the desktop, it has some small pictures with the name written under them. These small pictures are known as the icons. Each icon is representing its specific program. For example, we have discussed about recycle bin. So this is the system icon of recycle bin. There are some other icons present on my screen. For example, some application softwares are also installed on my computer, just like this Zoom, WhatsApp, and some Internet Explorers are also there, like Firefox. And there is another icon of a program which we use for programming, which is known as DevC++. So which means system software and application software both are having their own icons. For example, this recycle bin is the system icon which is already installed when we install the computer. But some application software like WhatsApp and Zoom and this Adobe Reader, these are installed when user install them after the installation of the Windows. As these are the application software, so it is not much necessary that our computers can work without them. So these small icons, these small graphics or pictures are known as the icon. Each program, file and folder is represented by the icon. Next, we have also discussed about the folder. For example, a folder has this type of skin or yellowish color. This is a folder, and this folder has, you can see some other folders and some other files. What is the difference between a folder and a file? A file is basically written as, has some type of icon which is of application software. Like I have a file over here named this AI issues and challenges for Pakistan. These are the files, all of these are the files, but these yellow icons are of the folder icons. When I'm going to open the folders, this folder having its own files. So a folder is mostly represented with this file type icon folder, like a physical folder that we exists, this yellow icon, and the rest of the icons are showing the application software. Next, we have said that besides icon, menus are also present in the Windows. So here, this is the start button in the left bottom corner of the window. If I'm going to click over it, it is giving me this menu. Okay, now it is very much easy for me to make selection just because of graphical user interface. I can see the long list of the programs that are installed in my computer. So the data is given in the form of menus, and it is very much easy for us to just by clicking any program, I can open that program. Next, we have talked about the window. Whenever I'm going to open a folder, let's say I'm going to click this File Explorer. this screen is open. This screen is known as the window. Each and everything is written in it. You can see it has some file with their names and their details. So in short, GUI, everything is present in the form of windows, icons, pictures. So that's why Windows operating system is easy for us to learn and to use as compared to the command line interface. For example, DOS. We have to memorize a lot of commands to use the DOS. As we have discussed that Windows operating system have the feature using which we can enter DOS commands also. So in search bar, I have typed CMD. After typing CMD, you can see the command prompt over here. I'm going to open it. So this is the basically, this is the environment in which we have used the command. You see, it is a very unattractive environment, which simply has the black background with the white text written over here. And there are no icons, and I don't know what files are installed, what files are saved, and what application programs are installed in my computer. And if I know the commands, then only I can use the command line interface. Otherwise, I won't be able to use it. Not only you have to know the commands, but you also know about the you should also know about the syntax of those commands. Each and every command has its own specific way of using it. So for example, I'm going to type in a command dir. This command is used to list all the files and folders that are present. And you can see I have typed dir and I'm going to press enter key. So after pressing enter key, it is giving me the list of the folders. You can see how much it is difficult for me to understand which folder contains what type of data and what. No icons, simply black and white details with some date and time. And it is at the end of the screen, it is giving me the message how many files are present in C drive. There are 3 files and 32 directories. Directory means folders. So if you know the syntax of the command, only then you will be able to use the DOS. Otherwise, it will be difficult for use. And also it is difficult to learn also, because you have to memorize the commands along with their syntaxes. So this is the environment known as command line interface, in short CLI. And the previously we have discussed GUI, graphical user interface. Now, I hope it will be easy for you to differentiate between command line interface and graphical user interface. Now, let's discuss about your today's task. Okay, I'm going to write in MS Word. So you have to attempt 2 questions. After attempting these 2 questions, please share your answers with me. When you will share your answers, you will be present as marked in today's class. Question number 1, you have to differentiate between GUI and CLI. You have to mention at least 4 to 5 differences with proper examples. And question number 2, what are the features of menu-driven interface? I hope you will find this task easy after watching these computer videos. So that's all for today. If still you are having some confusion, please ask anytime. Thank you.